पालम प्रेसेंस अनुभव फेस्टिवल श्री त्यागराज वैभवम।
डियर रसिकास, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस अनुभव फेस्टिवल ऑफ पालम एंड टुडे आई विल बी शेयरिंग विथ यू समथिंग अबाउट द Ghanaraga Pancharatnam of Shri Tyagaraja. When we say Pancharatnam, immediately our thought...
Dear Rasikas, Palam takes great pleasure in welcoming you all to the Anubhav Festival, which is the experiencing the beauty of our performing arts. We have been organizing this festival for the past several years, and this year we bring to you a very special topic, Shri Tyagaraja Vaibhavam, which is again a celebration of the great Vagekara and his wonderful compositions. This festival slated from 29th January to 2nd February. The name itself, I would say, could be given as Pancharatnam because this is a five-day festival where we are giving Pancharatnas to you in this whole festival. And we'll be having lecture demonstrations and concerts by eminent scholars and artists. You can watch this in our Palam TV, and in case you have missed it, you can always catch up on it through FB Live or in the YouTube also. Let us now look at the full schedule of the wonderful program that is slated for this 5 days. This year has been very tough, you know, for artists and the artist community because of the COVID pandemic. But from our end, we did not want to stop anything from keeping going. And we wanted to enrich our Rasikas all the time with good music. And that's why we are continuing now with this Shri Tyagaraja Vaibhavam Festival. May I appeal to all of you to contribute a minimum of rupees 500 or $10 USD. This is not compulsory, but if you feel that our cause is really worth it, we request you to please contribute so that we can do more for the arts and the artist community. Here are the bank details. Palam presents Anubhav Festival Shri Tyagaraja Vaibhavam.
Dear Rasikas, I am very happy to be a part of this Anubhav Festival of Palam, and today I will be sharing with you something about the Ghanaraga Pancharatnam of Shri Tyagarajar. When we say Pancharatnam, immediately our thoughts get transported to Thiruvayaru, the beautiful Samadhi of Shri Tyagarajar, the congregational singing by thousands of people together. It is indeed a sight to behold, I would say, especially the one when on the Pushya Bhagula Panchami day, all the musicians get together there to sing these Pancharatnas. Now, what is very, very unique about these Pancharatnams is that it has got a form, a structure and content which really facilitates, I would say, in terms of this congregational singing. If you observe intently at the Thiruvayar Aradhana when people are singing this Pancharatnam, It is very, very amazing, I would say, in the sense that we have top musicians participating in it. We have students who are just about learning, teachers or gurus. Then, of course, the performers of the other cadres. Then we also have rasikas. And sometimes I've also, when I've attended the Pancharatnam, I've keenly observed how many of them would have not even rendered the Pancharatnam before, but I've heard it so many times, and they would keep the book with them and try to sing along with the other musicians. So the whole point here is that it is the spirit of singing, it is the spirit of participating in that congregation, it is the divine experience of being there that makes people throng the place in thousands. So you would see that nowhere in the world, I would say, such a congregational singing actually happens in terms of the number of people participating in it. Of course, there may be a discordant note here and there, a shruti lapse, sometimes overlap of sangatis. But all this does not mar the spirit of the people in any way in terms of the singing. So once you have finished singing the Pancharatnam, you feel a sense of delight, you feel a sense of divine experience to sit in that sands of that Kaveri, you know, that Thiruvayaru, the banks of the Kaveri, and the Samadhi there, and all that adds to that beautiful ambience for that Pancharatnam singing. Now, I would like to share some thoughts as well as some information which I've been able to get in terms of these Pancharatnams. They are basically called as Ghana Raga Pancharatnam of Tyagaraja. Now, Ghanam, how did this term come about? When we look at it in terms of the Veena playing, we see that the Thanam playing was called as Ghanam. And these five ragas, Nata, Gaula, Arabi, Varali, Shri, they were actually used to play this Thanam in the Veena. And thus, this particular set of ragas became to be called as the Ghanaragam. And since the Pancharatnams happens to be in this Ghanaragam, it became Ghanaraga Pancharatnam. Now, the term Pancharatnam is also very, very interesting in the sense that in common parlance, we see Navaratnam. Navaratnam are the nine gems which we all know. Then what is this Pancharatnam? I would say that in the musical context, these are Ratnas by themselves. The five compositions are Ratnas of the highest order. And that is why we say that these are called as the Pancharatnas. Now, there is also a terminology use of Pancharatnai, Kirtanegal, Kritigal. Some call it Kirtane, some call it Kriti. But I personally feel that they are neither Kirtane, nor Kriti, nor Varnam, nor Sarajati, nor Thanam, none of these. But all put together a very, very unique form that has been created. So I would not actually try to classify the Pancharatnam as something boxed into a Kirtana or Kriti, but it is a class apart in itself, that it has got the components of so many different musical forms embedded in it. If you look at it, as I said, it's in a Kriti form of a Pallavi Anupallavi Charanam, or a Kirtana form of having multiple Charanas, or the Varna form, as you say, we have the Swaram Sahityam, or you could also call it a Swarajati. So how Tyagaraja has conceived this particular form, and also a form where the structure, internal structure is such that everybody can sing together, makes it very, very unique. Now, if you look at the Pallavi and the Anupallavi of each of these Pancharatnams, we see that especially the Pallavi, there may be some variations in terms of the Sangatis. Some may sing five Sangatis, some may sing six Sangatis. There may be variations in the melody of the Sangatis in the Pallavi and the Anupallavi. But as far as the Swara Sahityas are concerned, it is more or less codified by now. Earlier, of course, I'll be talking about that also in the history. Earlier, there were differences in terms of the, what we call as the sequence of the Charanas. It was quite different from what it is today. The number of Charanas differed, and the way they were structured also, there has been differences. But after the coming of these Pancharatnams in proper notation, I would say, by Sri Shamangudi Srinivasa Iyer, and then of course T.K. Govindra and many others who have made a print format for these particular Pancharatnams, they have got really codified, and now probably when everybody sings together, there is actually no differences. There may be some minor differences, but as such, at large, we see that everybody sings it the same way. Now, I would like to just share something about the earlier references to the Pancharatnam. It makes for a very, very interesting study. We see that in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini of Sri Shubbarama Dikshadar, we see that all of them have actually been called Kirtanas. The Pancharatna concept was also not there, and at that time, it's also important to see that only the four Pancharatnas, I mean the four out of the Pancharatnas, that is Nata, Gaula, Arabi and Shri, find a place in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini. The Varali actually does not happen to be there at all. And in 1975, the book published by Nanganallur Sri Tyagaraja Sangeet Samajam, you see that notation by Shamangudi Srinivasayar is there. And there he mentions again as Sri Tyagaraja Swami Galin Pancharatnam. This title I would like to make a mention here for the fact that the Ghana Raga, that term has not been used as a title here. He says that it is Sri Tyagaraja Swami Galin Pancharatna Kirtanegal. And when we see the original, we see that the Nate, there are about 12 Sangatis in the first line, Jagadananda Karaka. Then Jaya Janaki Prana, you see there are 5 Sangatis in the second line. And Charanam mentioned as Swara Sahityam only here. And also we see that, as I mentioned earlier in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini, the order of the Swara Sahityam mentioned there is quite different from what we sing today. And the particular Swara Sahityam in Natai, Nigama Niraja Brita Chaposhaka, the swaram is Sanipama Nipama Risa Nirisa. This is not found in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini, and it got added later into it actually. And again, also in the Gaula Pancharatnam, where we sing the first charanam, Re Re Sa Ni Sa Re Sa Sa, the first one which runs to 2 avartas, this is not there in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini and got added on later. We see that particular charanam in Shamangudi's notation, that book, you are able to see that particular charanam, but it is actually not there in the earlier version. Then we also see that the Satulakai, Satulakai in Arabi, that is mentioned as Swara Sahitya, but today we sing it as the Mudra Charana. These are all some of the changes that have happened. I just wanted to share with you. Then as far as Sadinchane is concerned, basically there is no change in the order, in the sense that Charanams as mentioned earlier are somewhat retained as such. And as I mentioned earlier also, the Varali Pancharatnam is not mentioned in the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini, but it finds a place in later publication. And the Pancharatnam as such, the name probably came into existence in the middle of the 20th century. Now let's look at some of the general features of the Ghanaraga Pancharatnam before we try to share something particularly about each of these Pancharatnas. We all know the Pancharatnas, Jagadananda Karaka, Dudugugala, Sadinchane, Kanakana Ruchira and Endaro Mahanubhavulu in the 5 ragas. And since all of you have heard it probably hundreds of times in your lives, whether you have been able to sing or not, at least you must have heard it so many times. So you'll be able to relate to many of the things I am going to talk to you. So the singing may not be much here, in the sense that all of us have heard these songs so many times. Well, among the 5, that is compositions, the first one, Jagadananda Karaka, is in eloquent Sanskrit, while the other 4 are in Telugu. That is the first thing. Then we see that in this particular Jagadananda Kara, it is more like an invocatory kind of approach to Lord Rama here, and he tries to extol the divine qualities of Rama. In fact, later on, probably I would say Tyagaraja never intended, or did he intend, I don't know about that. But later on, many people have tried to put together his Pancharatnam and seen that there are 108 Namavalis of Rama happening in this. Om Jagadananda Karakaya Namaha, like this, if you do Namaha Namaha like that, it counts to 108, including all the Charanas. When you try to take each word and try to make it into a Namavali, then you see that there are 108 in this. This is again something very special about this particular Pancharatnam. Then in the Gaula, you see that it is more like a very, you know, contrast you would see here. And it reveals the composer's fear that he should not become a victim to the human weakness. And here, actually, he's addressing his own mind. And he accuses himself that he has sinned without knowing the value of Rama Bhajana. And this could probably said to be like a sermon to humanity at large also. In fact, this quality we can see in a number of his compositions, where when he wants to talk about the sins, actually he is a great saint and he wouldn't have sinned, but trying to address the humanity, he addresses his own mind and he talks to himself and he says that he is a sinner, and that way he is trying to give us some kind of a sermon or some kind of advices which one should follow in terms of leading a divine and pure life. Then the Arabi piece, we would say, is like a Ninda Stuti actually, where Tyagaraja says that the Lord has had his own way by not coming near him and thus deceiving him. In Varali, he speaks about the Rama's splendor and the great joy attained by looking at his indescribable beauty, Kanakana Ruchira, that's a composition. Then Yendaro Mahanubhavulu, he pays homage to the great saints by the composer he's done here in utmost humility. Now, if you look at the Gana Krama here, we see that in Natai, Gaula, Varali and Shri, after each Swara and Sahitya, the Pallavi is repeated. And since there is no Etukada Pallavi as in Arabi, we see that this is a particular Gana Krama, in the sense that Jagadayanandakaraka. After that, we see that the Anupallavi is there. Gaganadipasat kulaja. And then after that, each of the charanam comes. And here, after each charanam, the Jagadanandakara, the Pallavi line gets repeated. This is also seen in the case of Gaula, Varali and Shri. But in Arabi, it's a slightly different kind of a format, where you have a Upapallavi, that is Sagadin Chenne O Manasagas. Then after that, Anupallavi Bodhin Chinasan Magav Chenamula. After this, you have the Upapallavi Samayaniki Tagu Matalade Samayaniki Tagu Matalade Pa Pa Magariri Magariri Sa 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 Da Da Pa Da Sa Sa Ri Ma Samayani. We don't sing Sagadin Chenne because of the fact that there is a Upapallavi here. Whereas in the other four, we saw that the Pallavi line gets repeated after each of the charanam. That is one thing I wanted to share with you. Then, in this Ganaraga Pancharatnam, we see that two of them are in Vivadi Ragam. The first one, not is a Vivadi Ragam. Then the fourth one, Varali, is also Vivadi. But what is important and beautiful, I would say, in the first Natai is how Tyagaraja has handled this Vivaditva very beautifully. All of us know that the Aronarana of Natai Sari Gama Padani Sa Sani Babaga Marisa Sari Gama Padani Sa. So the Shatshruti Devatam Padani Sa is there. But very interestingly, throughout the composition in Natai, he has avoided that Daivata and made it Panisa. So you would see sa sa ni pa 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 sa sa ri sa sa ma ma ri sa ma ma pa pa ma ma pa pa ma ma pa ma ma ri sa sa ni pa pa ma ma pa sa sa ni sa ni pa ri sa ni pa ba ri pa ma ri sa pa ba sa ni pa ba ri sa. So you can see in the other charan also pa ni sa or pa sa, like that, avoiding the pa da ni sa. So that Daivata actually, though it is supposed to be a part of Natai, does not find a place for itself in the whole of this Pancharatnam. Of course, the Sarigama portion has been handled very nicely. Sarigama pa pa ni pa ba ni pa ma ma pa ba ga ma ri sa ri sa ma ga ba ma sa ri sa ma ga ba ma. So sometimes sa ri ga ma becomes sa ri sa ma ga pa ma ni pa ba ga ma pa ni. So the intimacy of the ri ga is actually he tries to move it a bit away from each other so that it does not sound discordant. So that is something about the Natai Pancharatnam. Coming to the Varali, of course, where he has very gracefully handed that vivaditva pamagari sa kanakana ruchira kanakavasana nilnu. That beautiful elongation on the Gandhara, the beautiful gamakas on the Gandhara, and the contrast of the Pratimadhyama coming in, the typical Varali Pratimadhyama, all this add much towards the beauty of that particular competition. Like pa pa ma ba da pa ma ba da pa ma ga ga ri sa ri ga ri sa ni sa ga ri ga ma pa ma. Like this, in each of the swaras you would find how beautifully the vivaditva has been handled by Tyagaraja. Now we will try to look a bit more analytically on each of these Pancharatnam. First comes Jagadananda Karaka. As we all know, in today's rendition I'm talking about, I'm not going into what was there before. According to the today's rendition, the Jagadananda Kara happens to be the first piece in our presentation. Of course, the addition of other compositions to make it a complete whole, there is interesting information also on this, that how the Chetulara came into the fold of this particular whole set of compositions, or Sri Ganapatini and Guru Lekha. We'll offer some interesting study. We know that Tyagaraja lived from 1767 to 1847, and it was only probably in the early 20th century that this Aradhana, as such, a concept came into being. The Tiruvayari Tyagaraja Aradhana Committee, they wanted to have a singing coming together of musicians to sing together. And this Pancharatnam was found to be ideal, I would say, in terms of congregational singing. And we see that Bangalore Nagaratnamma, who was very, very, I would say, the most important person in terms of building this Samadhi, we all know, used all her lifetime savings to build this Samadhi at Tiruvayur for Tyagaraja. This congregation, we see that Bangalore Nagaratnamma was also invited, and she sang the 108 names of Tyagaraja that she had composed as a verse. And after this, we had Palladam Sanjeeva Rao, who played on the flute, and he played the Chetulara as the first composition. Probably from then on, this has become the tradition, and even today when we start the Pancharatna, we see that the flautist start off with Chetulara. And then, of course, we see that the next composition, as more, we say, of an invocatory nature, praying to Lord Vinayaka. So Sri Ganapatini, composed by Tyagaraja, has also been added. Then, of course, as a way of paying our obeisance to all the great gurus who have been guiding us, Guru Lekha has been taken into the fold, that also composed by Tyagaraja, and then the Pancharatnams. And earlier also, it's interesting to note that the Varali Pancharatnam was not known by many. In fact, It would also be say on a lighter vein that when the first three Pancharatnams are sung, there is a lot of volume, and then suddenly when the Varali comes to be sung, then many people go silent. This is again because of the taboo that Varali, when taught by the guru to the student, you know, the relationship gets strained. But that is a thing of the past, and today we could say that it is no more that way. And even if the guru does not teach the Varali Pancharatnam, we have other means of learning. We have the YouTube, cassettes, the CDs, and so many other gadgets through which we can learn. So today it's no more the same scenario, but at one time it was such that Varali was not taught to the student. So the Varali Pancharatnam as such was not taught directly by any guru to the student. But quickly I would like to add on my observation that Varali actually is not any such Vivadi Raga causing such kind of a strain, I should say, in the sense that if Varali was regarded as an unauspicious raga, I am sure that Sri Tyagaraja would not have composed Kanakana Ruchira in this ragam, where he tries to extol the beauty of Sri Rama and says that how much ever I see you, the beauty really captures my heart, and I feel that I should keep on and on and on seeing you. So this concept would not have been adopted by Tyagaraja if he did think that Varali was not an auspicious raga. Now, coming back to the Pancharatnams, some details. First, Jagadananda Karaka, as I said earlier also, here he describes the innumerable attributes of Sri Rama. Lord Rama is extolled by Tyagaraja. He praises the heroic deeds of Rama. And that way, I feel that Nata has been adopted very suitably by him. And Nata really is one of the ragams which depicts Veera Rasa. It is very majestic in nature. So the starting of the whole Pancharatnam with this Jagadananda Karaka in the Tarastai gives some kind of a beautiful, majestic and bright feel. Like when you start, Jagadananda Karaka, Jagadananda Karaka, that kind of a start on the Tarastai, and Anupallavi also in that same range, and the whole composition is so brightly done, and the Sahitya, I would say, and the melody complement each other very, very beautifully. Here you see that in the there's a Pallavi, there's an Anupallavi, followed by 10 Charanas, and unlike the Arabi or other compositions, there is no Etukada Pallavi or Anubandha here. So after the 10 charanas are over, you directly go back to the Pallavi and finish it. That is the format here. Now Pallavi starts, and then after that we have the Sangatis. There are many beautiful Sangatis here, and whether they were there earlier or not, gradually they got added to this, and now finally we see that it has become a beautiful composition in terms of how each Sangati beautifully kind of, you know, develops into the next one. Sequence has been done very, very nicely. And next we come to Dudugugala. Dudugugala again in Gaula. This again, I would say that the Sahitya and the melody, how Tyagaraja has conceived, is really very, very thoughtful, in the sense that it is in a very pertinent mood, and he preaches to humanity, including himself, to realize the worth of being born as a human being. So when it is in this kind of a very serene kind of a mood, a meditative mood, this Gaula comes to be a very, very beautiful ragam. And also we see that most of the composition is hovering more on the Purvanga and the Mandrasthai portion, that adds to that. Like for example, Dudugugala nanne dora ri ri sa 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 ri sa ri ma ma sa ri ma ni sa ri ma ma sa ri ga ma ri ri sa sa Dudugugala, like that, all that around, hovering around the Rishabha, giving focus on the Rishabha. Re 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 that all the swarams mostly you would see going around the Shadja and the Rishabha, and not too much into the Tarastai, adds to the element of the blending of the melody and the Sahitya very, very beautifully. And we also see that in this Gaula, what is unique is that while in ragas like Arabi, Varali and all, he has composed more number of kritis apart from this Pancharatna. In Gaula, we see that the only composition he has done is this Dudugu Gala. There is no other composition in Gaula composed by Tyagaraja. And till the fourth charana, we see that the Sancharas do not hover beyond the pa. As I said, it complements the mood of the lyrics very beautifully. Now, second charana, re re sa 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 re sa re ma ma sa re ma ni sa re ma ma sa re ga ma re re sa sa. That is the one of the important phrases, sa re ga ma re. But we see that only in the second charana, this phrase, sa re ga ma re re sa sa, is used. Otherwise, in all the charanas, it's like, he uses the phrase Pamarisa and not Rigamarisa. And eighth charana, the ma of Madhyama and Tara used as Nyasaswara, like pa pa ma ri sa ri ma pa ma ri sa ri ri ma sa ri ma ni sa ri ga ma ri ni sa ri sa sa pa ma ri sa sa ni pa 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 sa ni pa pa ma ri ma pa ni pa sa ni pa ri ri ma ri ma sa ri ma ri sa ni pa ni sa ri sa ni pa ma ri ma pa ni pa ma ri sa so ma sa ri ma. So that Nyasa of the Madhyasthayi Ma and the Tarastai Ma, they complement beautifully. And how the Ma has been each time focused here offers for some study in terms of understanding the aesthetics of the composition. And ninth charanam, we see that if you observe, all the four avartas, they end on the Shadja. So these are all some things which I'm sharing so that we enjoy the Pancharatnam more rather than looking at it as a yet another composition. Now, coming to Sadinchane, we see that, as I said, it comments on the deeds and pranks of Lord Krishna, and thus it is on a very lively pace. And though in Western music, we don't have any particular, as you know, the Kala Pramana, but we have a relative Kala Pramana in our system. And this Dudukugala is rendered in a medium kind of a tempo, whereas Sadinchane takes a slightly faster tempo when we usually normal in a Goshti Ganam, like Sagadinchane, oh, oh, mana saga, Sagadinchane. And here we have the unique format of Pallavi, Anupallavi, the Upapallavi, eight charanas, and then the Anubandham. And as I mentioned earlier also, the Upapallavi, Samayanikita Gubatalaedene, that is sung after each of the charanam. Of course, there has been another opinion on this by some musicians that more than Samayaniki, Sadinchane happens to be a more meaningful kind of a line to be attached to the charana, but then somehow this never got implemented, and still the normal format we see is that of everybody singing Samayaniki Tagu Matalaadana. In this Arabi Pancharatnam again, the thought process of Tyagaraja is absolutely amazing, where we know that Sarima Padasa Sanida Pamagarisa, that is the Aronarana of Arabi. But throughout this whole Pancharatnam, we see that in the Avarohanam, the Nishada has been avoided, and it is like Sada Pamagarisa. That is how he has used the Swaram as well as the Sahityam. And what is more important is that though the knee has not been used, which is actually there in the Avarohanam, you will never feel its absence. That is the artistry of the great composer, I would say, where he has used Sada Pamagarisa, but yet you would always feel as if the knee is there. Like pa pa ma ge ri ri sa sa da da sa sa ri ri sa ri ma sa ma ya ni ki ta gu ma ಕಟ್ಟಲೇಡೇನೆ ರೇ ಮ ಪ ದ ಪ ಮ ಪ ದ ದ ಪ ಮ ಪ ದ ಪ ಮ ಗ ರಿ ದ ದ ಪ ಮ ಗ ರಿ ರಿ ದ ದ ಪ ಸ ಸ ದ ರಿ ರಿ ಸ ಸೊ ಸ ಸ ದ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ ನಿ ದ ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಸ ದ ಆರ್ ಸ ಸ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಎ ರಾಗಂ ವೇರ್ ದಿ ಆರೋಹಣ ಅವರೋಣ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ನಿಷಾದ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಆರಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ನಾದ ಸುಧಾರಸಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಸನಿದ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಪ್ರಿಡಾಮಿನೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದೋಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಜೀನಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಪೋಸರ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ we would also like to make a mention here about the fourth charanam that you see in some of the written notation sanida pamagiri there is a fourth charana which has been added in the shamangudi's book also you would see that it is there but then we do not sing it most of us do not sing it and we delete it and go to the fifth charana the probably the reason here is that sanida pa seems a bit odd here this charanam is the odd one out I would say because none of the other charanams have got that nishada in it so probably I don't know how it got added or when it came but then in general practice after the third we generally move up to the fifth though in the notation of the print notation we see that there is a fourth charana with the sanidapa magarisa and coming to the number of avartas we see that the first second third and fourth all of them have got one avarta each fifth and sixth has got two avartanams and the seventh and eighth have got three avartanams each coming to now kanakana ruchira in varali and here as I said it is a deep ecstasy the deep joy that Tyagaraja felt describing the beauty of Rama that is the whole content of this particular kanakana ruchira and he says that how many times ever I see your beauty I'm never feeling satisfied about it so it's a beautiful state of the mind of seeing Lord Rama and the description of Rama that is happening in the Varali Kirtana and as I said the it's a vivadi ragam and we see that some interesting aspects about this is that in Sangeeta Sudambudi which was written in 1929 notation is there for the anumandam satatamu but the mentioned that notation for other charanas is not seen to be available here again in the sangeet kalanidhi by tachur singracharulu we see that the notation for the four pancharatnams I was mentioning is there but varali does not feature in this particular edition of his and tyagaraja haramu by k ramachandran in 1956 there it's very interesting to see how he reduces this particular varali kriti into some kind of kirtana format and says that all the charanas have to be sung verbatim in the same tune there are different versions as well as opinion about this varali pancharatnam but finally as I said earlier with the notations crystallized by Sri Shammagudi Srinivasa Iyer they have come to take a particular form and now we are able to follow the same thing again now and here we have the pallavi anupallavi followed by eight charanas and the anubandha in this there are a lot of swarakshara beauties we see like palugaru where pa is a swaraksharam or palar kabasuche there again pa is a swaraksharam or sapatima here sa pa ma sapatima sa pa ma all the three are swaraksharas or kaminchi in that ka and ga are swaraksharas and then also the endings how he brings about the end point in different ways to connect to kanakana ruchira is again a small study for students like ga re ga ma pa ma kana kana ruchi pa da pa ma ga ma kana kana ma pa da pa ma kana kana sa ni da pa ma kana kana ma pa da pa ma kana kana so when we are singing kalpana swaras probably these kind of ideas when we study intently we also understand the different approaches how it can have to the same theme line coming to endaro mahanubhavulu the fifth of the Pancharatnams. Sri is a very, very auspicious raga, we all know. And the name by itself, when we say Sri, it carries prosperity in itself. And interestingly, the Sri has been used by Dikshadhar also as the last raga in his Abhyamba Navavarna, or the, you see also in the Navavarnams, the Sri becomes the last ragam. So that way, Sri has got something very special about it as a very, very prosperous ragam. And here Tyagaraja uses that particular ragam to salute the great music stalwarts and eminent bhaktas who attain bliss by singing the greatness of Lord Rama. Here, of course, the most important mention is about the edupu of the composition. And as I always say, never before, never after. The composition starts on the little finger, and you can hardly find any composition of this nature. And most importantly, while it starts on this little finger, the charanas, each of these charanas start on the samam, and they end such that they fall seamlessly into the Yendaro Mahanubhavalu, which starts in the little finger. So it starts like Yendaro Mahano Babu Rigari Rigari Risani Sasari Sasari Sani Nigari Sarigari Risani Yendaro Mahano Babu. This also applies to the Sahitya, where it starts on the samam, but it ends such that it goes and falls into the Yendaro Mahanubhavalu. So this is absolutely a brilliant way of deciphering a composition. And also the point about not just a little finger, but also the fact that how the internally it has been structured, how internally the whole composition has been set to fit such that it starts on the little finger. The symmetry is something which offers for very, very interesting study. And though in Sri Ragam we see that in the Arohana and Avarohana, Sare ma pa ni sa, sa ni pa da ni pa ma ri ga ri sa. This is a normal Arohana, no? But the phrase pa da ni pa has never been used by him in the whole of this Pancharatnam. Sa ni pa ma is only what he uses. The pa da ni pa ma prayoga is not seen any of the stanzas of the charanams in or throughout the composition. You never see this padani pama prayoga. And how he focuses mainly on the key phrase in the beginning itself, yendaro marigarisa, which is the key, the heart of the composition, the heart of the ragam, I would say, has been captured in this composition so beautifully. And throughout the Pallavi, this phrase gets reiterated and repeated so that we get the full picture of Sri Ragam through this one particular phrase itself. Of course, then after that it is expanded and it blossoms very beautifully throughout the composition. And we see that except for the fourth charanam, all the charanam starts on the Rishabha or the Panchama. Like this we can keep going on and on about the Pancharatnams. And the more deep we go into these compositions, we understand that there is so much more to learn, so much more to unearth here. And especially in ragams like Nata, Gaula, which are all supposed to be ragas of limited scope, he has shown us that it can be made very vast, it can be made really very, very great and big through his composition, the Pancharatnams. And without repetition, without monotony, how many varieties and combinations of notes he is able to give us through these Pancharatnams is something very, very amazing for us to study. And of course, the Sahitya again, how it beautifully complements the melody, complements the ragam that he has chosen for each of this Pancharatnam is again another very, very interesting study. And of course, no Aradhana is complete without these Pancharatnams. And though we may have so many compositions, again here, on a last note, of course, I would like to just make a mention that the Pancharatnam here is indeed very, very unique in the sense that unlike even Tyagaraja's own other Pancharatnam like Kovur Pancharatnam, Lalgudi Pancharatnam, Sriranga Pancharatnam, where the theme is that particular deity of that place, here the Pancharatnams are actually not connected in terms of the theme at all, because each of the composition has got a different theme structure in terms of the Sahityam. If you take, each one talks about a different subject, but then the format of the whole 5 has brought them together. The format of how the Pallavi Anupallavi Swara Sahityam is structured is what has brought these 5 together as the Pancharatnam. And in terms of the congregational singing, they are the most unique, I would say, because we also have other group kritis of Dikshadar, like the Navavarnam, Navagraham, or the Swarajatis even of Shama Sastri. But then all of them, they cannot be rendered together unless you practice it intensely. But these Pancharatnams, I would say, of Tyagaraja are absolutely magical, in the sense that whether you know little music or whether you know much music or whether you are a starter, everybody can join together, and even by following the book, you can just try to sing along and participate in that divine experience. That way, I think we all owe a lot in terms of gratitude to that great Vagyekara, who has given us in bountiful, and especially this Pancharatnam, because they help the musicians to come together and through the medium of music. And in a larger perspective, I would say that this music helps to bind the entire humanity together. Music as a unifying force, we say. And that way, I would say that the Pancharatnam is one of the greatest forces which not only unites musicians or students, but it unites the entire art community very beautifully. And that's why I say that the Pancharatnam holds tall and one of the most unique and unparalleled compositions in the history of Carnatic music. Namaskaram and thank you.
Yes.
This year has been very tough, you know, for artists and the artist community because of the COVID pandemic. But from our end, we did not want to stop anything from keeping going. And we wanted to enrich our Rasikas all the time with good music. And that's why we are continuing now with this Sri Tyagaraja Vaibhavam Festival. May I appeal to all of you to contribute a minimum of rupees 500 or $10 USD. This is not compulsory, but if you feel that our cause is really worth it, we request you to please contribute so that we can do more for the arts and the artist community. Here are the bank details.
Oh,
ಮಾಡ I'm not afraid.
Mama. Oh,
Mi menu na
zare kare zare zare ma pani baba mare pa mare re ni baba zare ba
This year has been very tough, you know, for artists and the artist community because of the COVID pandemic. But from our end, we did not want to stop anything from keeping going. And we wanted to enrich our Rasikas all the time with good music. And that's why we are continuing now with this Sri Tyagaraja Vaibhavam Festival. May I appeal to all of you to contribute a minimum of rupees 500 or $10 USD. This is not compulsory, but if you feel that our cause is really worth it, we request you to please contribute so that we can do more for the arts and the artist community. Here are the bank details.